the name of the Lord our God, Jesus Messiah. With one voice we sing our praise and make a joyful sound to the King of Kings.
For joining us in this special program, where as a nation and as a church, we will come together in prayer and song during this challenging time. So pray with us and sing with us as together we lift up the Lord on high.
We are living in a perilous days, uncertain days. And so today, I would like you to join me as I pray. Let us join our hearts together in prayer, asking God to intervene and help us and protect us. Let us all open our hearts before God and let us pray. Almighty and loving Father, we are living in a very uncertain days. COVID-19 is destroying lives, bringing people to bed, getting sick, and not knowing what to do. There's no vaccine. But you are our Lord, you are our God. You are the creator of heaven and earth. In you, Lord God, is our help. And we know, God, that as we come to you, Lord God, today, we can find refuge. We can find protection because you are our loving God. You are the creator of heaven and earth. You created our bodies. And you know exactly, Lord God, what is good for this body. You know exactly what is the right medicine to help us overcome this COVID-19 virus. Father in heaven, have mercy on us. As we come before you, Lord God, we ask you, Lord, touch your people once again. We need you, Lord God. We need you, Lord God, more than anything else. But first, Lord, we want to ask for forgiveness for all the things, the sins that we have done, the things that did not please you. Because we believe, Lord God, that is the sin that we have committed that caused all the trials, the troubles that we are now facing. As you have said in your word, if we will come before you humbly, seeking your face, praying unto you, Lord God, then you will hear from heaven. Forgive us, Lord God, from all our sins. Cleanse us with your blood, that we may be protected and that we may be saved from the onslaught of the COVID-19. Father, you are our great God. You love your people. And you are the faithful keeper of your covenant of love towards us. And have mercy on us, Lord God, as we intercede for all the people all over the world. We ask you, Lord God, first, touch those that are sick, those that are in the hospitals, those that are quarantined in their homes. Lord, touch them. Wash them with your powerful blood, that they may be cleansed and may be saved. Lord, touch them that they may be healed and that they may be able to go back to their normal lives and be saved from the effect of COVID-19. We commit them to you, Lord God. Wash them and heal them. You are our healer, and we know, Lord God, that just by saying your word of God of healing, people will be healed. Thank you, Lord God. And also, Father, we thank you, for we know you have touched so many people who have given their lives, sacrificing their lives, their families, their careers. They are the health workers. They are the frontliners. They are the ones facing the enemy COVID-19. They are the ones facing it, Lord God, to fight it out. And we know, Lord God, that with you, they will be protected and they will win the war against this virus. Cover each health workers, the doctors, the nurses, the volunteers, even other people that are being used by you, Lord God, to contain the spread of this virus. Protect them, Lord God. Shield them. And Lord, we also pray for those who are making decisions, the leaders of countries, the leaders that you have given before us or above us. Give them wisdom. Give them, Lord God, the knowledge to know exactly what to do. Father, they cannot make wrong decisions. So, Lord, we pray, touch them that they may have the right decision, Lord God, to make policies on how to curb or stop this virus and protect the people that you love. We commit unto you, Lord God, the leaders of nations, countries, cities, and towns. And so also, Lord God, we pray for the religious leaders. We pray, O God, that you continue to anoint your leaders, your chosen leaders, that they may, Lord, also be able to continuously pray for your people. That through their prayers, O Lord God, people would be touched by you. People would be able to also come to you, Lord God, because of these leaders that you have chosen to help them, especially in their spiritual lives. Father, we pray for the scientists, for the doctors, that they may have the ability, the wisdom, the knowledge to be able, Lord God, to create and form the vaccine that is needed to put an end to this virus. Give them the ability, the resources, Lord God, that they may be able to do it, Lord God, so that new vaccine will be available to cure all the patients and protect those that are not yet sick. And Lord, we also pray for the families who have already lost their loved ones. Lord, comfort them. Give them strength, especially these days, very trying days. Touch their hearts, O Lord God, that they may be consoled, that they may be comforted by your Spirit. Lord, we submit ourselves to you. You are our God. You are our Creator. Have mercy on us. Father, thank you. For we know, Lord God, that you are listening to our prayers and that you are responding to our prayers. And this is our faith, O Lord God, that every prayer of your people reaches your heart, O Lord God, and your compassionate heart is going to do something right now to touch your people, us, and you will stop COVID-19. Father, we thank you, for we know the morning, the day that will come, will be days of health, safety, and people will again be able to gather together to praise you, to glorify you. Father, we thank you for listening to our prayers. And this is our prayer, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus and through the help of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, God. All glory and honor belongs to you. We praise you. Thank you, Father. Amen. Thank you. And this prayer may be short, but if you take this to your heart and you have joined us, we know, God, that this will become a powerful prayer that would touch the heart of our Father. God bless you. God bless us all. And let us unite our spirits together, praying to God to be protected and be healed and be kept safe. from COVID-19. God bless you all.
Kagapon po sa ating mga kababayan, batid po natin ng buong mundo. Maging ang Pilipinas ay lubhang apektuhan ng COVID virus. Marami na po namatay at kasalukuyan ay nasa ospital at sila po ay ginagamot ng kinaupunan. Muli, sa pagkakataon ito ay lumapit tayo sa Panginoon at humingi ng kanyang habag-atawa upang mapagtagumpayan natin ang krisis na ito na ating pinagdadaanan. Bago tayo manalangin ay basahin po natin ang banal na kasulatan at ito ay nakasulat sa 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, the creator and sustainer of everything, all praise be to you for the infinite graces, wisdom, and love you have bestowed upon your people. Forgive us, O Lord, for all the sins we have committed against your will. In this moment, we lift up to you the one triumph God, what the world is facing and your people is experiencing this coronavirus that has claimed lives and has affected many. In spite of this, we continue to live with purpose for your great glory by serving and protecting our fellow men. Bless us, O Lord, as we endure to deliver with integrity, honesty, and justice the rule of law and our undertakings as law enforcers. Merciful God, intercede with us in this moment as we put together hand in hand the directives of our beloved Chief PNP for the welfare of each law enforcers and their families in the delivery of humane and altruistic services in the community and our professional growth in the Philippine National Police. All this we ask in your mighty name. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Mga kababayan, tunay nga na tayo ay magtiwala at umasa sa Panginoon at tayo po ay kanyang papatnubayan at mapagtatagumpayan natin ang krisis na ito. Muli, ito po ang nilikot si Reverend Police Captain Fulgencio Cañon Jr., Chief PRO, PNP, Chaplain Service. God bless us all.
Isang pagbati po sa inyong lahat at kamusta po kayo? Sa Biblia po, noong pong pinahirapan at nakulong po si Pablo at si Silas, ang ginawa po nila buong magdamag ay manalangin at umawit ng mga himno at papuri sa ating Diyos. Mainam siguro sa mga panahong ito ay magkaroon po tayo ng payapa na nanggagaling sa ating Diyos. Sabi nga niya, "Be still and know that I am God." At ang maganda pong gawin natin ay manalangin po tayo, umawit po tayo sa Kanya upang mapayapa po ang ating mga alalahanin sa buhay. Yan po ang gawin natin.
Nagmumula sa puso ko itong awit. Papuri ko'y sa'yo pagkat tinubos ako. Kaya't awitin ko'y sa'yo si Jesus ang aking musika. Nagbibigay sigla sa bawat titik at nota. Si Jesus ang aking musika. Sa akin at sa saad ang bawat awitin na si Kristo'y buhay sa ang hatid. Nagmumula sa puso ko itong awit. Papuri ko'y sa'yo pagkat tinubos ako. Kaya tawitin ko'y sa'yo, oh, oh, si Jesus ang aking musika. Nagbibigay sigla sa bawat titik at nota. Si Jesus ang aking musika. Sa akin at sa saad ang bawat awitin na si Kristo'y buhay.
Sa akin.
ka.
Frontliners, thank you for everything that you are doing for this country. I pray God's protection over you, His strength, and His wisdom. Your sacrifice is not in vain. God bless you.
Praise the name of the Lord our God, Jesus Messiah.